Welcome to another video by Jesco the Rising Phoenix Dev, and today we are going to go over the event of people not wanting to follow my last set of advice and is dead set on the idea of
I want to learn both my game engine of choice and programming language at the same time.
And you know what? That is perfectly fine. Although, I personally don't recommend going that route as outlined in my previous video on this subject. However, I do have suggestions for you if you really want to go that route. You can actually use some very classic and simplistic games to build that are great for building some solid foundations. I will keep this as language and game engine agnostic as possible so that it doesn't matter which one you use, you will be able to use this advice. The classic games I am suggesting for you to first recreate are Pong, Breakout, Centipede, and Space Invaders. Each of these games are small enough that you can easily recreate a single level of and solve the problems presented by them, which definitely goes into one of the biggest assets a developer can have, the ability to solve problems. From these four classic games, you could then move on to more complex classic games like Pac-Man, Galaga, Donkey Kong, and Frogger. These four games present more complex challenges that build upon what you would have learned from the previous games. These include slightly more complex AI in the games, two environmental hazards. Following these, you can move on to Paperboy and Commando. These will lay the groundwork for more AI on the screen, more environmental hazards, and boss battles. Then, if you really want to get fancy, you can try to recreate Mega Man, Super Mario Bros., Metroid, and Castlevania. Each of these really stand out for level design, more complex character movement and AI, along with matching gameplay with the overall tone. This would allow you not only to learn the programming side of game development, but also aspects that are more able to encompass the whole of game development. The key point to all of these recreations is not to try to find tutorials or walkthroughs that hold your hand and walk you through how to do these things step by step. You should try to figure it out on your own, and when you get stuck on a problem, there is no shame in looking for a solution to a similar problem to learn from it. Now, this doesn't mean to just copy the code blindly. Rather, you should try to dissect the code and really understand what it is doing. Doing all of these would cement your understanding of building games, designing levels, building AI, and programming. The only downside is that it would only be focused on your game engine and programming language of choice. So my next suggestion would be to pick up and try to learn another game engine that uses the same programming language so that it can be used to expose you to more of your programming language and how drastically different the programming is between them. This would most assuredly get you ready to handle most single-player game development hurdles and paves the way for being able to do 3D as well. You could further compound these ideas by trying to incorporate a simple peer-to-peer networking game to learn about networking with game development. Following this, if you feel you are ready to begin tackling 3D game development, there is some very important information to know right off the bat. 3D game development is technically just an extension on 2D game development. So many things you learned from your previous practice with 2D will carry over. It is at this stage that you should be able to think of or be inspired by other games to try to implement mechanics from them, which leads me into my present series that I'm working on where I implement game mechanics from well-known games in three different game engines. This has been Jesco the Rising Phoenix Dev, and remember, this is just my advice and it is up to you to decide if you want to give it a shot.